In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In October of 1918, Blessed Karl of Austria led the consecration of his family to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. After having become Emperor of Austria a few years earlier in the midst of the terrible First World War, Karl undertook valiant efforts for peace. At this point, though, he was in exile and was experiencing a very painful illness. Through all of these sufferings, which would lead to his death, Emperor Karl allowed his heart to be transformed by the Sacred Heart of Jesus. On his deathbed, he declared, "It is so good to have faith in the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Without it, the hardships would be impossible to withstand." Blessed Karl kept an image of the Sacred Heart under his pillow throughout his life, and it was a source of great strength and consolation. On April 1st, 1922, Blessed Karl received the last rites, and shortly after noon, he kissed the crucifix and whispered, "Thy holy will be done. Jesus, Jesus, come. Yes, yes, my Jesus, thy will be done, Jesus." And as he spoke the holy name, he died at the age of 34. Blessed Karl had been for a time both the Emperor of Austria and the King of Hungary, and was a saintly ruler. As he recognized, his authority came from Christ the King, and he also was a loving and faithful husband and father. 3 years after his death, Pope Pius XI wrote an encyclical entitled Quas Primus, which established a new solemnity in honor of Christ the King, which we celebrate today. In the first reading, the prophet Daniel has a vision of a one like a son of man who received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples and nations will serve him. His dominion is everlasting, his kingship shall not be destroyed. In the responsorial psalm, we heard, "The Lord is King, girt about with strength." Then the second reading, the beginning of St. John's apocalyptic vision, we hear, "Jesus Christ is the ruler of the kings of the earth, has made us into a kingdom. To him be glory and power forever and ever." In the gospel today, Christ acknowledges that his kingdom does not belong to this world, and does not deny he's a king, but explains it in a different sense than Pilate could understand. "For this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." Christ's kingship is unlike any worldly kingship. It is not based on power, but on truth and love. In his encyclical, Pius XI stated that it would be a grave error to say that Christ has no authority in civil affairs. With Jesus Christ excluded from political life, with authority derived not from God, but from man, the result is that human society is tottering to its fall because it no longer has a secure and solid foundation. Through baptism and confirmation, as Catholics, we are called to be heralds of the truths of Christ and his church. In the early part of the 20th century, the apostleship of prayer noted close connection between devotion to the Sacred Heart and his kingship, stating that to establish the reign of the Sacred Heart in the family is to prepare and inaugurate its triumph in civil society. In the day in which all families are officially consecrated to the adorable heart of Jesus, its public reign in the state will be close by, or even have already begun. Pius XI noted a certain slowness and timidity of many good Catholics reluctant to engage in battle, which resulted in the enemies of the church becoming bolder in their attacks. But if the faithful were to courageously fight under the banner of Christ their King, then fired with apostolic zeal, they would strive to win over to their Lord those hearts that are bitter and estranged from him, and would violently defend his rights. This past week, Archbishop Vigano released an appeal for an anti-globalist alliance, expressing grave concerns about the fundamental rights, which up until yesterday were presented as inviolable, have been trampled underfoot in the name of an emergency. And he notes, the current emergency is that of a health emergency, but warns that future ones could indeed come soon. Interestingly, just a few days after this open letter, the government of Austria issued a national lockdown order and mandatory COVID jab and boosters for all citizens, with violators facing heavy fines and even imprisonment. This formerly Catholic nation is the first one in Europe to mandate COVID injections and booster shots, and again will apparently forbid Catholics from coming to Mass for some time. In some parts of the world, it is difficult or even possible for Catholics to attend Holy Mass because of this health emergency, which has been going on for over a year and a half. So today's feast of Christ the King ought to be a call to us to spiritual battle, to be heroic soldiers of Christ. One of the best aids to equip us to do this is to make the Christ the King of our homes by the enthronement and family consecration to the Sacred Heart. When a Catholic consecrates himself to the Sacred Heart of Jesus, he is recognizing Christ's dominion over him, and inspired by love, consecrates all his faculties to our Lord. As St. Margaret Mary says, the adorable heart of Jesus wishes to establish his reign, the reign of his love in all hearts, and to destroy and ruin that of Satan. A family consecration seeks to draw the entirety of the family to live this out, which is really nothing other than ultimately living out our calling to be a saint. In addition to the family consecration, there is also a home enthronement in which an image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus is placed on a kind of throne or pedestal to show that our Lord's heart is now the king of the home and the family. The enthronement of the Sacred Heart of Jesus as king of the family is also a way of dethroning Satan and all his wicked influences. I've been blessed to lead the consecration enthronement in countless families during my years as a priest, and I'm always happy to come to your home to do so if you so request. For those who've already done the enthronement and consecration, it's of greatest importance to daily renew this consecration, even by a short family prayer to the Sacred Heart before the image. Once you have done the enthronement in your home, you need not repeat the entire ceremony if you move to a new home, although it is good to do a brief ceremony and a new enthronement in your new home. With the help of our Blessed Mother, St. Joseph, Blessed Carl, and all the angels and saints, may we be courageous soldiers of Christ our King, aided by consecrating ourselves and our families to his Sacred Heart, so that we'll be more and more, he will more and more be the loving king of our home, our hearts, our minds, our homes, and even our nation and world. In so doing, we will also grow in the hope of one day experiencing the wonderful promise of St. Paul, his letter to the Colossians, that God our Father will deliver us from the power of darkness and transfer us into the kingdom of the Son of his love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.